Here's some of the news on InfoWars.com right now. Rand Paul, Obama embroiled in old McDonald farm of scandals. They're a pig, here a pig, everywhere pig, pig. I mean, it is just scandals and corruption everywhere. And will you guys punch up my computer screen? I want to show viewers this. So again, here is InfoWars.com. Oh, it's not connected. We need to do that every day at the start of the show. Here, I'll do it. I'll connect it so we can run that feed out to everybody. Or it may have disconnected on its own. Is it connected now? Okay, so back to InfoWars.com. There you can see Rand Paul, Obama embroiled in old McDonald farm of scandals. DHS memo warns 3D printed guns may be impossible to stop. Oh my gosh, it's so deadly. People may have guns. Criminals are going to have them anyways. But the big criminals don't like that. Gang of Eight says, trust us, this bill will pay for itself. The $6.3 trillion amnesty bill that legalizes criminals. I don't mean just criminals for being here illegally. I mean felons. Maybe they can join the police force. There's some towns actually hiring illegal aliens as police in New Mexico. IRS harassment. Suppressed Tea Party vote. Gee, think that was what it was for? Mike Judge defends Second Amendment and more, an exclusive interview with Alex Jones. That full video that we played the audio of yesterday on the radio is now up for everybody at InfoWars.com. And it's and you're like, okay, we all know the guns are good. Well, your friends and family don't. And he's got a lot of fans. So it's a really good, it's almost a documentary. In fact, parts of it are. I'm really proud of the interview. Please get it out to everybody you know. Will Lois Lerner be Obama's scapegoat? An important article. Yeah, I think that's the plan. Under Obamacare, health insurance want cash on the barrel head. How do you like that? And the price is doubling. Eric Schmidt, Google AI indistinguishable from humans within 5 to 10 years. And that means they've already got it, ladies and gentlemen. That's why they're so arrogant. The people will believe what the media tells them to believe. So said George Orwell, a.k.a. Eric Blair. That's just some of the news up on InfoWars.com. We'll look and see what Drudge is doing in a little bit. But let me go ahead and just get to this right now. Hey, I meant to read this first hour. I didn't get to it, so let's read it now. Fox News. Roger Ailes' letter to Fox employees. Dear colleagues, the recent news about the FBI's seizure of the phone and email records of Fox employees, including James Rosen, calls into question whether the federal government is meeting its constitutional obligation to preserve and protect a free press in the United States. Well, it's going to soon be a conspiracy that there ever was a free press. I mean, everybody knows there wasn't. All there are re-education facilities, but never mind that. We reject the government's efforts to criminalize the pursuit of investigative journalism and falsely characterize a Fox News reporter to a federal judge as a co-conspirator in espionage. Yeah, and I added that part. A federal judge as a co-conspirator in a crime, but it's actually of espionage. For talking to a State Department official about what's your personal view on Kim Jong-un? Is he crazy enough to really test a nuke? Well, I think so. So they arrested him, and he's now in jail. I mean, this is like saying you can't. I mean, that's why I can't even get generals and colonels on now. They say if they give their opinion about the weather, they'll be arrested. I mean, well, I've gotten so many documents we've put out. I mean, if a government's doing something illegal, you have a right to talk about it. And the government is illegally spying on you so that to stop you from that. This is outrageous. I mean, they're disappearing people. He goes on to say, Roger Ailes, I know how concerned you are because of so many of you have asked me, why should the government make me afraid to use a work phone or email account to gain news or gather news or even call a friend or family member? Well, they shouldn't have done it. The administration's attempt to intimidate Fox News and its employees will not succeed, and their excuses will stand neither the test of law, the test of decency, nor the test of time. We will not allow a climate of press intimidation. And I'm telling you, the globalists are really asking for it, because there's a lot of corrupt power blocks, but they don't want to be slaves either. You know, they get that basic instinct that, you know, that the gravy train's going to end if they let one power, one ring to rule them all, and in the darkness bind them, come into power. We will not allow a climate of press intimidation unseen since McCarthy era. McCarthy was a good guy, folks. I'm going to explain that in a minute. To frighten any of us away from the truth. He was misled, though. I am proud of your tireless efforts to report the news over the last 17 years. I stand with you. I support you, and I thank you for your reporting with courageous optimism. Too many Americans fought and died. Oh, this is the right type of talk. Finally, really calling them out. This is the only way to deal with tyrants, folks, is call them on it. Too many Americans fought and died to protect our unique American right of press freedom. We can't and we won't forget that. Be an American journalist is not only a great responsibility, but also a great honor. To be a Fox journalist is a high honor, not a high crime. Even this memo of support will cause some to demonize us and try to find irrelevant things to cause us to waver. Yeah, like saying no one should listen to me and that I'm insane. And I mean, they're scared, folks. We will not waver. See, what's happened is Fox and Glenn Beck and all of them, they wouldn't cover this stuff. But Infowars.com, this show, my films, and then Drudge supercharging us like nitrous oxide at the key junctures with real reports. He went and looked up, and his crew looked up and found out we're accurate. That's why they keep hurting them, because it's true they've got FEMA camps. It's true they're buying billions of bullets. It's true their manuals say they're going to arrest returning veterans and libertarians and conservatives, and that we're the enemy and there's this coming war with us. I mean, these people are the radical, dangerous folks. And you've got to call it what it is to confront it. Yeah, it's over the top. Yeah, it sounds nuts to say what they're doing, but they're the ones doing it. You know, it sounds crazy to say your neighbor's got dead bodies in the back, but if you've seen them and you know they're there, you got to go call the police. I mean, I know why people don't want to believe this, but it's happened. He goes on to say, even this memo of support will cause some to demonize us and try to find irrelevant things to cause us to waver. We will not waver. See, they get distractions. Or Mad Owl desperately, her body language is freaking out. They're all freaking out right now. As Fox News employees, we sometimes are forced to stand alone. But even then, when we know we are reporting what is true and what is right, we stand proud and fearless. Thank you for your hard work and all your efforts. Sincerely, Roger Ailes. And I know for a fact Roger Ailes has bodyguards, former FBI and a Navy SEAL. I know for a fact Roger Ailes secretly, at least 20 years ago, was an anti-New World Order guy. I've talked to multiple people, a bunch of them that knew him when he was younger. And he is not a communist or a socialist and secretly doesn't like the New World Order. Rupert Murdoch's a different kettle of fish. But still, they're more opportunistic. They're not like really hating America, really hating families, really hating men. They just kind of halfway have gone along. But now because they brought out Benghazi, and by the way, it was our guest, our research that helped force that out again about the missiles and all of it and the Al-Qaeda. I mean, let me tell you, folks, this country is in a civil war right now between different power structures. And the really nasty globalists that want to shut this country down are in charge at the White House. And they are so freaked out that I've got their number. They are so freaked out that we've hit the zeitgeist that if they're ever going to kill me, it'll be soon. And I don't want that to happen, but I'm committed to this. So just please pray for us. Spread the word. And as bad as Fox News is, and they've done mean stuff to me in the past, they are, I've told everybody this, when they start shutting stuff down, they're going to get rid of anything that even acts like it's libertarian or conservative. Because it could be the ghost, the seed that could grow into something real. You understand that? Even though they've been fake opposition, they will be destroyed unless they wake up.
Visit Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. When you're on the site, you can also tune in 24 hours a day to my daily radio broadcast. There's also a free iPhone app to listen to the syndicated radio show when and where you want.